I've spent a lot of my career giving people feedback. In fact, I've spent about 30 years delivering feedback to leaders and managers. Now, the way I originally did it was we'd show people feedback and we'd compare them to the average of all the other managers in the organization. And I was always interested as I'd give people feedback and their data was about at the average. I was interested in their reaction. Now, what I'd do is I'd give people their feedback, I'd see their data was about right at the average, maybe a little bit above, and I'd watch people's reaction. Now, here's what I'd often see. Big smiles, very happy. People were really satisfied with being a little bit above average. And when I'd ask them, why are you so happy? Their comment was, well, I'm not a bad leader. They'd experienced bad leaders before, and they knew the damage that a bad leader could do. They didn't want to be a bad leader, and they wanted to be a good leader. But they were satisfied with being good. And we thought that was kind of a problem. You know, as we look in organizations, we see a lot of good leaders. In fact, there's probably too many. But one of the real problems we found is that good leaders sort of assumed that they were great. They assumed that good was great. When we did a series of research studies and looked at a whole bunch of different variables, what we found was there was a huge difference between good leaders and great leaders. And we found differences in terms of their ability to get results, in terms of their ability to be profitable, in terms of their ability to satisfy customers and having committed employees, customer satisfaction, ability to retain the best talent. Good leaders were better than bad, but great leaders made a great difference. You know, I find leaders in every organization trying to do everything they can to create some competitive advantage. They're looking under the carpet for pennies. They're trying to create more efficiencies. They're really working hard to do everything that they can. Every variable out there. Oftentimes, the one variable they miss is leadership. I mean, if you knew about a variable that affected profitability, customer satisfaction, employee engagement and commitment, turnover, wouldn't you want to be better at it? But again, the difference isn't around bad to good. Most leaders I work with are good. The difference is between good and great. And our challenge for leaders is to go from good to great. How can you do that? Well, it's a different process than you think. It's a unique process because intuitively we think we have to be perfect. In The Extraordinary Leader, we show you how to make that transition from good to great. And you'll be excited to learn that it's different than you think.